If you're working with clients for your online business, then your email should be impeccable. I have had many occasions where I actually lost prospects and existing clients because their email didn't reach me, or my email was caught in their spam filters or didn't send out completely. It was horrifying and it's costing me loads of money. So this time I switched to another company. In this video, I'm gonna show you exactly how to get Microsoft 365, how to connect your own email address from your own domain name to Microsoft, and I'm going to show you how your WordPress website can send all the emails from contact forms and notifications all through Microsoft 365 completely free. Follow this to the end and all will be good. Let's start right now. Let's first get Microsoft 365. If you already have it, you can skip this step. If you don't and you want to help me out, go to wp.discount/365 or click on this link. It's also there. You go to the comment section. And here we are at the Microsoft 365 business plans. What do we have in here? The most important thing is the business class email. Now, this is what we actually want. But you also get 1 terabyte of cloud storage per user with OneDrive. Excellent. You can use Microsoft Teams, but you can also use the web apps, Word, Excel, PowerPoint, Outlook. This is actually a really good deal if you have your own business. Excellent. Also, this comes with a free month and it will only start billing your credit card after the first month. So if you don't like it, we've set it all up and you don't like it when using it a month, you can cancel it. That's okay. We're going to press on buy now. And then we're gonna set up our subscription. You can choose between yearly build or monthly build. The price is exactly the same, so you just choose whatever you want. We press next. Here we need to fill in our email address, which we want to use with Microsoft 365, with your own domain name. So in my case, it's gonna be the@wpressdoc.com because I want to route this email address through Microsoft 365. Once you have filled it in, we press on next. Then we're gonna press set up account. We're going to fill in our details. Once we have filled it all out, we press on next. Then they're going to do a security check to see if we are really who we say we are. You get a text message from MS Commerce and we're going to fill in the verification code. Then we're going to press verify. Now we can choose your username. In my case, wpressdoc.com, and the username will be the@. Press save. Then we're going to create a really strong password. Make sure to save that password somewhere safe because it's very important. Press next. Then you're going to choose how many people you want to use with Microsoft 365. We're going to use one. We're going to press add payment method. You can use a credit card or direct debit, what you want. Fill it all in and then we're going to press over here on save. Then we're going to review and place our order. Just check that everything's all right. The quantity, your name, your address, your credit card, and the estimated tax and your total payment. When everything's all right, we're going to press place order. Save your username and your password on someplace safe. Then we're going to press on start using. And then we have to sign in, of course. So sign in with the email address we've just created. Press next. Then we're going to enter in our very strong password and press sign in. If you're on your own PC, you can please press yes. If you're on a public computer, don't press yes. Well done, we have logged into Microsoft 365 Admin Center. And this is the place where we can set things up and control everything, like your billing things, but also your mail, your cloud storage, everything. How experienced are you in managing Microsoft 365 for an organization? Well, I've done it before, so I'm gonna click this one and we're gonna press submit. Now the fun part begins. We're going to set up our own email address within Microsoft 365. Click on set up email with custom domain. And then we're going to click on use the domain name we already own. And then we're going to add it in. Adding your domain name without the www. Or the HTTPS. Just this. Press on continue. Now the next step to do is of course to verify our domain so that we actually own it and we can send emails from our domain name. So head over to your hosting company where we can change the DNS settings. Don't worry if your hosting company is different. You're looking for something that's called the DNS editor or change DNS. And in there, you can see all these things, the A record, AAAA, CNAME, MX, SRV, TXT. This is all good. Don't worry, we're gonna do this step by step. So make sure in your hosting company, you find the right place. What we then need to do is we're gonna add a txt record. So in this case, the name is at or skip, and the value is this one. So copy this value, copy, go over here to txt, and we're gonna create a new one with a value of this one. We're gonna leave this empty for root domain, and the value is this one, and press create. Now that record is created, let's get back to Microsoft. When we have added it, we just press verify. Now it's gonna verify our domain to see if everything works, and congratulations, you've done it correctly. Now we're gonna add in our official email address we want to use from with Microsoft 365 with our domain name. In our case, I want to use the@wpressdoc.com, or maybe just matt@wpressdoc.com, why not? When we press update and sign out, we have to sign in with this email address. Watch this. It's a good idea to close all browser windows. How do we get back, you say? No problem at all. Microsoft 365. And then we're gonna press Microsoft 365 login over there. And then we're gonna press here sign in, or on the top corner over there, sign in. And then the account is already here, but we're gonna use another account, the@wpressdoc.com. And we're gonna press next. Enter in your password and press sign in. Here we go. Now we are locked in with our own email address on Microsoft 365. Congratulations. We can see all this information. Yes, pretty good. Okay. Now this is the Microsoft 365 dashboard. Here you can go to Outlook, to Word, to Excel. This is from here. We were, just a minute ago, we were at the admin page. So we're going back to there. So click on admin. Now you can see we are back at the admin center. And the next step is to make sure that all emails go through Microsoft 365. To do that, we also have to change the DNS. We're gonna create three new records or change the existing ones. So the first one to do is use an MX record. Make sure to press this button to copy the value. And then we go back to our hosting company. And then over here, we're going to look for a MX record that's already there. As you can see, we already have one, which is this one from SiteGround itself. We have 20 and 30 priority. We're gonna add a new one with priority 0. So we go over there. We're going to the MX record, and we're gonna add your own MX record over there. Then we're gonna have the destination will be this one. The priority should be 0, and the name should be empty. We're gonna press create, just like this. Wait a second, it has been created. Oh, I forgot something, the TTL should be 1 hour. So we scroll down back to our newly created MX record with the priority 0, press on the edit button and put on the cache duration of 1 hour. Press confirm, like this, excellent. Then let's get back to the admin center. And we scroll down and we're gonna add another record, the CNAME record. The host name should be AutoDiscover, so copy this one. And look for a record called AutoDiscover, it already might be in there. Now, if you already have an AutoDiscover record like this one, A, and we need a CNAME, we're gonna delete this one. Don't worry, you can always put it back from your hosting company. And we scroll all the way up and we're gonna add a CNAME record. The name should be autodiscover.wpressdoc.com. Cache duration should be 1 hour. Let's get back to the admin center. It resolves to autodiscover.outlook.com. Copy it, paste it in over there, and we're gonna press create. The CNAME record is also created. Well done, last step. We're gonna add the TXT record to help prevent spam. Now this TXT record might already exist in your hosting company. Don't worry, we're just gonna add it. We're gonna copy this one, TXT value. Then we go back to our DNS records. And if you scroll down, you have to look at a value which says F is SPF. Here's one, as you can see, it's already in there. Now we're gonna edit it. Don't remove it, just edit it. And over here you can see all these things, plus, includes, SPF, all. Now, before all, we're gonna paste in what we've just copied, paste it in. But now we have two alls. So we're gonna remove the last one. Now we have the one from Microsoft. And in here, you can see this, F is SPF1, but it's double now. So we're gonna remove this one and just add in with one space. So it should look something like this. F is SPF1, and then you have all these things from your hosting company, which is fine. This IP address is also is also good. It's one of your hosting companies. Then we have another one of my hosting company. And then I have sbf.protection.outlook.com. Minus all. That's it. And make sure to put this one on 1 hour and press confirm. Now, this is very exciting. If we press now on this button, connect email, it's gonna check if it's all good. If you've done it correctly, well done, I'm proud of you. And then you can see that you're all set to use email. Excellent. If something went wrong, don't worry. Just go back a few seconds in this tutorial and try to do it again. This time, make sure to really do it thoroughly. Well done, your domain name and your email has been connected to Microsoft 365. Excellent. If you now want to go and use your Outlook for the web, you go over here to all these dots and you can use Outlook, Word, OneDrive, Excel. You have 1 terabyte of OneDrive, so that's actually pretty amazing. If you're in the online business, I always put all my client stuff in my OneDrive cloud, because in there, it's safe and it stays there, and whatever happens to my PCs, I'm still good. Now let's connect our WordPress website to Microsoft so that it also sent all the contact forms and everything from my website straight through Microsoft 365 to my clients and prospects. We're gonna do that right now. Log into your WordPress website. If you're still logged in using WP Admin, not a very safe way, so please watch my tutorial about securing your WordPress website, because you don't want to get hacked. Now this is really safe. We need to make sure that WordPress sends all emails like contact forms and admin notices through the systems of Microsoft 365. We're going to connect that at the right way. We have to authorize your WordPress websites to send emails using Microsoft. The first thing we need to do is we go to plugins and we're gonna add a free plugin to do that for us. Fluent SMTP. This is the one we need to have. We're gonna press install now. I used to use this one, but WP Mail SMTP just asked a lot of money. So we're gonna press activate. And then we go over here to the settings of Fluent SMTP. Now here we are at the Fluent SMTP settings. We're gonna choose Microsoft to create a connection over there. We're gonna fill in your email address from Microsoft 365 and create a from name that people will see when they get the mail from your WordPress website. In our case, Matt Doctor, like this. Then we scroll down and we're gonna copy this one. Copy it. The first thing we need to do is get an application client ID from our Microsoft 365. To do that, we go over here, we're gonna add a new tab, and you go to portal.azure.com, like this. Press enter. That's from Microsoft. We have to sign in with Microsoft Azure. You can only do this with your newly created Microsoft credentials. So in my case, d@wpressdoc.com. We're gonna press next, gonna enter in the password and press sign in. Press yes. And then we are locked in into Microsoft Azure. Now we don't want to show me around, so press maybe later. Follow me along. We go up here and we type in app registration. And we're gonna click on this one, app registrations. Then click on this button, new registration. We're gonna use a name that can be anything, just for your reference. In our case, it's the WordPress. Make sure that who can use this application should be this one. Accounts in any organizational directory and personal Microsoft accounts. And then change the redirect URI to web. Then we go back to our WordPress website over there, app callback URL. Just copy this one. Go back to your Microsoft Azure and paste it in over there. Here we go. This looks great. And after that, we press register. Successfully created application. Well done. The next step is to copy the application client ID. So we're going to copy it. We go back to WordPress and we're going to fill it in over there. There is our application client ID. Well done. Go back to Microsoft. Then we go over here to certificates and secrets. And then we're gonna click on over here, new client secret, and enter in a description, for example, WordPress secret like this, and we click on add. Successfully updated, well done. And then we're gonna copy the WordPress secret value, click on it, go back to WordPress, and fill it in over here. Well done, let's see if everything works. Press on this red button over there, and then they ask for permission is requested. We want to have the WordPress connection. All these things are good, and press accept. Then we get an access code. As you can see over there, it's pretty big. Make sure to copy this entire thing. So press right click, select all and press copy. and add in your access token right there. Here we go, paste it in. And the last step is safe connection settings. It all looks good, so let's see if it actually works. Go over here to email test, over there. And we're gonna send an email from the@wpressdoc.com. And I would suggest to send it through a service not from Microsoft, not from your own website, so like your Gmail. And once you've put it in, you press send test mail. Hooray! Test mail has been successfully sent. And then you log into your Gmail and hooray, congrats, test email was sent successfully. Now you know that all emails from your WordPress website is being sent through Microsoft 365 inside all your clients and prospect mailboxes. Now, if you see over there that the name is not correct, as you can see now that there is math instead of what I filled in, we go back to WordPress, go to your settings, and then we're gonna force the sender name. So then it should be this one. Go down and press save connection settings. And now in the next version, you can see that, hey, my name is correctly done. If you have any questions or you just want to say thank you, Matt, drop it down in the comments. I'll always reply. Hit that like button if I helped you out and make sure to subscribe over there because I have a lot more viewers than subscribers. After that, check out this video, which has nothing to do with email. I think.